It's this poor nerdy guy. This is his first trip back to Santo Domingo after many years, and so he has this kind of overwhelming impression. And it goes like this. After Oscar's initial homecoming week, after he'd been taken to a bunch of sites by his cousins, after he'd gotten somewhat used to the scorching weather, after he refused to succumb to that whisper that all long-term immigrants carry inside of them, the whisper that says, you do not belong. After he'd gone to about 50 clubs, and because he couldn't dance salsa, merengue, bachata, had sat and drunk presidentes, after he spent a couple of quiet mornings on his own, after he watched shirtless, shoeless 7-year-olds fighting each other for the scraps that he left on his plate in an outdoor cafe, after his mother took them all to the zona colonial for dinner, after he'd taken a dump in latrine and wiped his ass with a corn cob, now that, he wrote in his journal, is entertainment. After he'd gotten somewhat used to the surreal whirligig that was life in Santo Domingo, the guaguas, the cops, the mind-boggling poverty, the Dunkin' Donuts, the beggars, the Haitians selling roasted peanuts at the intersections, the mind-boggling poverty, the asshole tourists hugging up the beaches, the chica de Silva novellas where homegirl got naked every 5 minutes, the mind-boggling poverty, the snarl of streets and rusted zig shacks, the masses of niggers he waded through every day who ran him over if he stood still, the skinny watchmen standing in front of the stores with their broken down shotguns, the music, the raunchy jokes he heard on the street, the mind-boggling poverty, being pile-drived into the corner of a gonjo by the combined weight of 4 other customers, the music, the new tunnels driving down through the bauxite earth, the signs that ban donkey carts from the same tunnels, after he'd done the Boca Chica in Villa Media, after his tío Carlos Moya berated him for having stayed away for so long, after he heard stories about his mother, after he stopped marveling at the amounts of political propaganda plastered on every wall, after the touch to the head deal who'd been tortured during the Balaguer regime came over, after he caught his first sunburn in Boca Chica, after he'd swum in the Caribbean, after Dio Rodolfo had gotten him blasted on Mama Juana de Marisco, after he'd seen his first Haitians kicked off a bus because someone claimed, in quotes, they smelled, after he'd nearly gone nuts over all the BDSs he'd seen, after he helped his mother install 2 new air conditioners, after all the gifts they brought had been popularly distributed, after Lola introduced him to the boyfriend she dated as a teenager, after he visited all the rinky-dink museums in the capital, after everyone had called him gordo, or even worse, bingo, after he'd been overcharged for almost everything he wanted to buy, after La Inga prayed for him nearly every morning, after he caught a cold because his abuela set the air conditioner in his room so high, he decided suddenly and without warning that he was going to stay on the island for the rest of the summer. Thank you.